honored to serve you as your governor.
Governor Martin O'Malley's eighth and final legislative agenda has been put to rest, and the state's 90-day legislative session is now over. One of the biggest surprises was O'Malley's 11th-hour decision to sign legislation decriminalizing the possession of small amounts of marijuana.
He did announce early in the session that he was opposed to marijuana policy reforms, and just like on marriage equality, where he started out not being for it but evolved when he saw the will of the people, he's now announced tonight that he'll sign that bill.
The increase in Maryland's minimum wage to $10.10 over the next 4 years was a top priority for the governor. There were battles along the way, but it survived and now awaits the governor's signature. Still, there are some who hope for even more.
Maybe one day we'll actually get to a living wage where people can support their families. I was very disappointed that they took the tips out.
The House Minority Leader has his own disappointments, like the General Assembly's failure to lower income taxes and make the state more competitive.
It's not a Democrat or Republican thing. There are other blue states with Democratic governors who have booming economies and booming surpluses to their revenue in the state treasury.
The governor's future remains unclear, but Kipke believes O'Malley's prospects may have influenced his decision-making these last 90 days.
I think it was pretty much a political session, which has been so much of what's been going on under Governor O'Malley's term. He's positioning himself, I think, for a national-level politics.
O'Malley has admitted he's looking at a 2016 presidential bid, but for now, it remains just in the talk stages. At the State House, I'm Emily Stern, CNS-TV.